So thanks for showing me Scrintal. I'm really excited about the tool and I'd love to see how you're using it.
Yeah, of course. So if you're someone starting from scratch, this is where you land in. So on this desk, Scrintal is, well, it looks like an infinite whiteboard, as you can see, and you have a sidebar here. And on this desk, you can create cards. We call them cards, not documents. So you can double click anywhere. Let's just call it new card. But the interesting part is like this card looking thing is a fully fetched document actually. And you can create links. Let's say new link. So you can either like press plus and then create a new link card. Yeah. And when you create a new link card, as you can see, like two things happen. I create a visual link on my desk. And I also create like a new card at the same time. So Scrintal is like both has the text capacities and also it's a visual first tool actually. So whenever you create cards, they land on your desk and you can create linkages and we draw these arrows automatically so that you can really move them around, give them the visuality that you want. You can fold things, you can change colors, you can even make Kanban type of boards. And let me, if you like, show you a board that we already created so you can see some of the use cases. So this board actually includes so many cards, as you can see, but we organize it visually so that as a startup founder, before you make a pitch, here you can see all the sections of your pitch, all the sections that a pitch should have, and all the questions that you should be answering. So it's such a complex use case, actually. You have probably like 50 different questions. And Scrintal is like, as I said, it's an interesting way to visualize information that could go into a 50-page report. So I can double-click open any of these cards. And you can see that I can embed or upload any media file. So you can embed a video. And the nice thing is you can extract these videos or PDFs or images or tweets. And while you're like keeping on typing here, you can keep watching and you can go around. So the whole idea is that whatever you need to finish a project should fit into one screen and it should make sense visually to you. And you can like basically in terms of the visuality, go as crazy as you like. And you can simply create new boards out of the boards. So I can select like this section and I can create a new board out of it. And the same cards will exist in both boards, but this board is a new visuality. So if I want to turn this into a table type of structure, I can do so. I can simply create like a Kanban table here just because let's say that I want to turn these same cards into to-dos this time. Yeah. And so that's like the main idea about Scrintal, that cards are our main units and they're permanent and they live in one single archive. And you can create different visual boards out of these cards, but the boards are simply a visual representation. So you can reach your archive with a spotlight search or from a search here, and you can simply utilize the same cards across different boards.
And any individual card can have a lot in it, right? It can have text, it can have a video inside of it, it can have multiple different sections, exactly. Right? So you can open up any card and have a richer subnote, basically.
Exactly, that's correct. And also the links that these cards have, they retain. So you can see that this card has these links, all these links. And if I take out all of its links from this board, it will still keep its links. So you can see that we take the card and anything it has as the one permanent thing. And it's just simple visuality. If I want to add one of its links to this board, I can do so. So taking cards or removing them does not mean you're deleting them from the system.
So people are using this to plan out projects, to think about different ideas for something they're creating or writing. What are a couple of other common use cases that you're seeing that people are using this for visual organization?
Yeah, it became such a commonality that when you have a little bit complex project at hand, for example, studying for an exam, or many people say, I need to create a 20-minute speech. it's going to be about our organizational goals, and I don't know where to start. So anything that requires a bit of brainstorming, because you can simply populate this board with cards, like with a single click, and anything that requires a little bit of storytelling goes really well with Scrintal. So creating, making podcast structures, creating pitches, studying for exams, creating a course curriculum, or mapping out two different literatures and try to see visually which concepts do they overlap. Like, those are some great use cases.
And then when you're done, you can share it by just publishing it, right? Or share a PDF of it, the board, collaborate with others.
So you can simply, when you're done, you can either share it with another Scrintal user so that you can both go inside this board and work at the same time live. Or you can, for example, there are so many teachers making a board for a classroom, and they publish this board with a secret URL, and they share the URL with their students so that the students can go in and read in a read-only mode, and they can interact with the cards. They can open them, but do not change. So they simply do the reading, or they understand what the class is about before the class.
Great. Thanks for this demo. It's a great tool. It looks like there's a lot coming with it as well as it continues to grow. So thanks for sharing it. Do you want to just point to a couple of big things you have coming up for 2023 as we see it grow?
Yeah, of course. So we realized from our users that they all come to Scrintal with an end product at mind. For example, like creating their next article or creating their next sales page. So in 2023, we will be focusing on how we can make these boards into end products so much more quickly, how we can turn them into linear end products, and also quickly give ways people to summarize all the boards and create a sense-making product, basically. And we will be having very interesting releases in 2023.
Great. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.